members of this nonprofit organization. In no particular, well, in somewhat of an order, but we'll start with the fellows of this group, John Fonji Kudo. I have known Poppy for 35 years, I think.
1936.
I met Poppy when I first met Bruce in Seattle. I was 18 years old. I was a young, naive, Guaylo girl who all of a sudden was falling madly in love with her kung fu instructor, who was a dashing and vibrant, worldly Chinese man. And from the depths of the wisdom of this man here, he counseled us as we tumbled head over heels and held the hand of my trembling mother as Bruce and I were joining the wedding bliss. And he continued to hold my mother's hand for years as she came to know and to trust and to love her son-in-law through the eyes of his best friend, Poppy. Poppy thinks of Bruce as his sifu and his teacher. It's equally true that Poppy did serve as a guide, a mentor, an advisor, and a role model, like a parent and certainly a friend to Bruce. And Bruce would not have become the man that he became, this confident newcomer in a strange land, and the devoted friend and family man that he did become without the guidance of this man, Poppy, right here. Well, and tonight, for all these reasons and many more, John Fonji Kudo wishes to pay tribute to Sifu Poppy Kimura for his years and years of dedication to the preservation and perpetuation of his friend Bruce's art. Poppy is the heart and the conscience of this organization. His goal is pure, is unadulterated by commercialism or by politics. He seeks only to honor his friend's work, to preserve it for future generations. And for that, we pay tribute to him tonight with a plaque that Andy has for him. Senior brother, the John Fonji Kudo, and I'm sure all of you.